Hello, good day to all my Form 4 students. Today we are here to look at the chapter Acid, Bases and Salts, part 12. In fact, this is the last part for our chapter 6 and we are going to wrap up this chapter from this part. Now, last video, Part 11, teacher was discussing on qualitative analysis of gases, 8 type of gases, and I categorized the gases according to their characteristics, neutral, acidic and alkaline. And teacher discussed about how to identify cations using sodium hydroxide and also ammonia. But because we had a constraint on the amount of space on the board, teacher couldn't discuss one more subtopic on how to identify cations. Here it is. Teacher going to discuss on the special test to identify few extra cations. Okay, so now let's go to, so I want you to look here. Okay, I want you to look here because we had space constraint in our video part 11. So teacher had to discuss this first because it's regarding cation. Then teacher will go to anion. Right? Now, so let's go to special test on how to identify lead ion. Okay, so you have a special test to identify cation, which is lead. When you add any salt containing sulfate ion, chloride ion and iodide ion, lead will give you white precipitate. When teacher say WP is white precipitate, with lead to chloride, it will produce white precipitate. So when teacher write lead, sulfate ion, lead ion, that means you add any salt containing sulfate ion or chloride ion or iodide ion. For instance, lead to nitrate, teacher add potassium iodide. Can you see, as long as I have iodide ion in it, just to check extra the presence of lead. So when I add anything to do with iodide ion, for instance sodium iodide or potassium iodide, it will produce yellow precipitate. So this is how you identify lead ion. Extra test other than sodium hydroxide and ammonia to test the presence of lead. Now let's go to iron 2 ion. You have extra special test where you use a substance called potassium hexacyanoferrate 3. In order to test iron 2 ion, you use potassium hexacyanoferrate 3 where dark blue precipitate is produced. Dark blue precipitate, okay, is produced. Now let's go to iron 3 ion. Okay, so iron 3, can you see the pattern? In order to test iron 3 ion, you use potassium hexacyanoferrate 2. In order to test potassium, sorry, in order to test iron 2 ion, you use potassium hexacyanoferrate 3. In order to test the presence of iron 3 ion, you use potassium hexacyanoferrate 2. Can you see the pattern? And again, you will produce dark blue precipitate. Okay, you produce dark blue precipitate. And in our previous video, teacher did not mention about ammonia. Why? Because I don't want you all to get confused. Ammonia is also, even though it is a non-metal atom, ammonium ion is considered cation because it brings positive charge. In fact, ammonium ion has no effect on when you're trying to test it with sodium hydroxide or ammonia. No change. So that is the reason why you have a special test to detect the presence of ammonium, which is you use Nestle Regal, you will produce brown precipitate. Now please bear in mind, anything to do with nitrogen, you will have brown color. Okay, that's one thing I want you to remember. Anything to do with nitrogen, like nitrogen dioxide, it's a brown gas thanks to the presence of nitrogen. Okay, so you will have brown precipitate when you use Nestle reagent, that confirms the presence of ammonium ion. Now let's look at aluminium. Okay, so aluminium also has a special test, but the test is when you use anything to do with sulfate, iodide or chloride ion, no precipitate produced. Okay, no precipitate produced. In fact, guys, what you can do is you can use, in order for you to differentiate between the presence of aluminium ion and lead 2 ion, you can use sulfate ion or iodide ion or chloride ion to see whether it has lead ion or aluminium ion inside the salt. Okay, so that's how you test the presence of aluminium or lead ion. Okay, so I hope you can understand extra special test to detect the presence of lead ion, iron 2 ion, iron 3 ion, ammonium ion and also aluminium ion. Now let's move on to qualitative analysis to test the presence of N ion. Okay, so again teacher would like to highlight why we are testing qualitative analysis for cation and N ion. Why? Because salt is made up of N ion and cation. Okay, cation, just say X plus Y negative. So it makes a salt XY. Okay, so that is the reason why when you are testing for cation, you must test for the anion also. Okay, some anions, they can produce gas when you heat them up. For instance, like your nitrate ion and carbonate ion can produce gases when you heat them up. But unfortunately, your sulfate and chloride ion, they are too stable. They don't disintegrate or they don't dissociate into a residue or gases when you heat them up. Okay, so that's the reason why you have to go through anion test. Okay, now let's go to four types of anion. So in our previous part 9 video, teacher told you that for your syllabus you have four types of salt: carbonate salt, chloride salt, sulfate salt and nitrate salt. In order for you to get a salt associated with carbonate ion, you use hydrogen carbonate. For you to get a salt that has chloride ion, you use hydrochloric acid. For you to get a salt which has sulfate ion in it, you use sulfuric acid. And for you to have a salt which has nitrate ion in it, you use nitric acid. Can you see the pattern? Okay, now so let's go to how to test the presence of carbonate ion. Okay, so what happens is you add hydrochloric acid to the salt. Okay, so you get a gas which changes lime water chalky. That's all. Okay, so that's all. Where the moment you add acid, in fact not only hydrochloric acid, can be any acid also. Why? Because carbonate ion can react with hydrogen gas, can react with acid to produce carbon dioxide. So when you add in here, when you add example hydrochloric acid, you add into a salt containing carbonate ion. So when it produces a gas that turns lime water chalky, you know that this is carbonate ion involved. The ion involved in the salt is carbonate ion. Okay, now let's go to chloride ion. Teacher just give you a few examples. So you add nitric acid followed by silver nitrate. Okay, so now if you look at part 10 of teacher's video, you will know that part 9, if I'm not mistaken, point 5, where you must know, I told you that you must know the solubility of a certain salt. So what is the rule for solubility of chloride salt? All chloride salts are soluble in water except for argentum chloride and lead 2 chloride. I hope you can remember this. So hope you can go back to part 9 video of teachers, okay, where teacher discussed the rule for carbonate ion, chloride ion, sulfate ion and nitrate ion type of salts. So the rule for chloride ion is all are soluble. Who is not soluble? Argentum chloride and lead 2 chloride are not soluble. So now you can understand why teacher had argentum nitrate, because I want to produce argentum the moment white precipitate. The moment white precipitate is produced, teacher know that it is argentum chloride ready. So the only ions who can produce precipitate with chloride ion is lead 2 ion and argentum ion. Okay, so please remember, the moment teacher say I am testing this salt using argentum ion, you know it is chloride ion. That is how you understand the pattern. Okay, now so let's go to the rule for sulfate ion. All sulfate ion are soluble except for calcium sulfate, lead 2 sulfate and barium sulfate. So I want you to remember this before we start. Okay, now how you can test the presence of sulfate ion is you add hydrochloric acid followed by barium chloride. Okay, if you add hydrochloric acid, you follow with barium chloride, or if you add nitric acid, remember this pattern, you add barium nitrate. Itu sahaja. Okay, you add barium. If you want to add barium chloride, you must add hydrochloric acid. If you add barium nitrate, you must add nitric acid. Now, can you see the pattern here? Why do you think out of all the salt, teacher use barium ion? Why? Please go back here. Because barium produces white precipitate with sulfate ion. Okay, so barium produces white precipitate with sulfate ion. So you get barium sulfate, which is white precipitate. Okay, so that's the reason why this rule is important for you to know. Okay, this rule is important. Now let's go to nitrate ion. Nitrate ion, all you have to do is you add dilute sulfuric acid. Okay, so teacher use the formula of the molecule. Okay, the formula you can look up in any books. Followed by iron 2 sulfate. Followed by concentrated sulfuric acid. Teacher repeat, add dilute sulfuric acid followed by iron 2 sulfate followed by drops of concentrated sulfuric acid along the wall of the test tube. Now, what have I told you all regarding nitrogen? Anything to do with nitrogen, you will have brown. Remember? So that is the reason why don't be surprised when you find brown ring produced. Okay, brown ring produced. So I hope you can see the pattern. It's all about pattern. Salt is all about pattern. Anything to do with nitrogen will have brown. Nitrogen dioxide, brown gas. In order to test ammonium, Nessler-Reagan brown precipitate again. Now, to test the presence of nitrate ion, dilute sulfuric acid, followed by iron 2 sulfate, followed by few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid along the wall of the test tube, you will get again brown ring. So, that is how you test nitrate ion. Okay, so teacher repeat. Carbonate ion prefers to produce carbon dioxide. So when you add any type of acid, it will produce a gas which changes lime water chalky. So that is actually carbon dioxide. okay, that is actually carbon dioxide. Now, chloride and sulfate might be a bit troublesome. Why? Because one thing only teacher requests from you all is you learn the pattern, which is what are the rules for chloride salt. Chloride salts, all chloride salts are soluble except for argentum chloride and lead 2 chloride. So when teacher say I want to use argentum, the reason teacher introduce argentum ion because argentum chloride, when you add to any chloride salt, it will produce argentum chloride, which is white precipitate. Please remember that. So the moment you produce white precipitate with argentum ion chloride salt. Now let's go to sulfate salt. So you must remember what is the rule for sulfate salt. All sulfate salts are soluble in water except for barium sulfate, calcium sulfate, lead 2 sulfate. You might be wondering, teacher, why I cannot use lead for this? Okay, the reason why is because lead can mislead you. When you add lead in chloride salts, it also produces white precipitate. When you add lead in sulfate ion, it also produces white precipitate. So this can mislead you. So you'll be thinking, am I testing chloride salt or sulfate salt? So you might have to do double job, which is you might have to go through maybe all these extra tests to test whether it's really lead to ion. So that is the reason why we prefer anything to do with chloride salt, use argentum ion, easier. Anything to do with sulfate salt, use barium ion, easier. Okay, calcium sulfate, because it's quite insoluble, that's the reason why. Okay, now, so what happens is, you use barium. The moment you see barium ion, confirm you're trying to test for sulfate ion. So that is the pattern that I want you to know. Alright, okay, so teacher stop here for our last part of salt. Okay, so that means we have finished chapter 6 of form 4. Teacher will continue our lesson in our next video. Till then, thank you for watching and see you all.